Well, it finally happened. All four Philadelphia coaches fired in the same year. With nowhere else to turn, they were all but forced to band together and form
the League of Inadequate Coaches.
Doug Collins, having lasted 3 years or less with the four NBA teams he has coached, he moonlights under the alias Burnout. His real strength comes in the myriad of minions he's accrued over the years. Of course, they also serve as his weakness, as most of them have already tuned him out. His strategy is to get close to villains, raise their expectations, and then shatter their hopes and dreams. Now you see me, now you don't. Peter Laviolette walks the night as Expletivo, letting curses fly like wildfire. Although his rampages get the league fired up, he often runs out of curses and loses his train of thought. Everyone knows his special move is to run up to his villains and
rip their heart out of their f***ing chest.
Although we can't legally say it, his catchphrase is, let's f***ing get a f***, like f***ing corndog curse. Charles Manuel, a.k.a. The Mumbler. Known for his slurred speech, his only weakness is trying to communicate with other members of the league. He takes down villains by simply having a conversation with them, driving them to the point of insanity. Nobody can determine his catchphrase since nobody can tell what he's saying. When creating their outfits, he told the costume designer that he wanted a great costume that was also foreboding. And Andrew Reid as, you guessed it, the Fat Man. Known for Taco Tuesdays, Fast Food Fridays, and eating everything in sight. His only weakness is salad. He often employs his special move known as the stink palm. He'll sit for hours with his hands in his sweaty armpits and then attack his prey with a candid handshake. If he said it once, he said it 1,000 times. I gotta be a better slob. With their powers combined, they are the League of Inadequate Coaches.